and praise the Lord. Welcome to today's service. Thank you so much for joining us today. We are glad that you are here. We just want to take some time and just begin to praise the Lord because He has been good to us. I know that He has been good to you because the fact that I can see you here, I know that the Lord has been good to you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the living God. Are you ready to praise the Lord? Why don't you just clap your hands unto the Lord? Yes, Father, we thank you, we glorify you, we honor you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Indeed, there is no one like you, Lord. What are you turning to wine? Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. Darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, none like you. Let me declare that sing. What are you turning to wine?
What are you turning to wine?
Open the eyes,
open the eyes of the blind.
Yes,
there's no one like you.
Tell the Lord, none like you. Into the darkness you shine.
Into the darkness you shine.
Out of the ashes we rise.
Out of the ashes we rise.
Say,
there's no one like you.
No like you.
Not like you.
We sing our God.
Our God is greater.
Yes.
Our God is stronger.
God, you are higher than any other.
Awesome in power, our God,
our God,
our God.
What shall say, our God?
Our God is greater, our God is stronger.
God,
you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God.
Come on, just move to the right and to the left, yeah. If you know that there is no one like Him, and if you're clearly that He is great, yes, Lord, we bless you, we glorify you, Lord. There is no one like you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. One more time, we declare, what have you done?
What are you turning to wine?
Open the eyes of the blind.
Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you,
not like you, Lord.
Darkness you shine.
Yes, and out of the ashes we rise.
Out of the ashes we rise.
There's no one,
no one like you.
Not like you.
Not like you.
We sing and say, our God.
Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer. Awesome in power, our God,
our God,
our God.
One more song we say.
Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer. Awesome in power, our God,
our God,
our God.
We say,
and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand?
And if
our God is for
and
us,
if
then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand again?
Say,
stand again.
One more time we say,
stand again.
What can stand against us?
Stand again.
One more time we sing. And if our God is for us, say.
And if our God is for us, then what could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand again?
Say,
stand again.
What can stand against us?
Stand again.
Yes. What can stand against me?
Stand
there
again.
Is nothing that can stand against.
God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, help me say,
our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God,
our God,
our God.
And if our God is for us, who could ever stop us?
And if our God is with us, then who could stand again?
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is,
then one can stand again.
Say,
stand again. Stand again.
Stand against us.
Stand again.
Come on, just worship him in your few words. Come on. He's a good father. I'm so glad we belong to him. He's a good God. Hallelujah. We praise you, Jesus. There is none like you. You are awesome in this place. Come on, see. He's a good God. Hallelujah. Church, I want us to declare this with me. It simply says, sing Jesus.
Jesus, Savior. I'm yours.
I'm yours. I'm yours. I'm yours forever. I'm yours. I'm yours. I'm yours.
Sing, Lord, I'm yours. Lord, I'm yours. I'm yours. I'm yours forever. I'm yours. I'm yours. I'm yours.
Hallelujah. Such a privilege to have a God who we belong to. He says in his word that we are no longer ours but his. Hallelujah. Come on, church. Declare it again. Say, Jesus.
Jesus, Savior. My life belongs to you.
Sing, Master. One time I said, Jesus,
Jesus,
Savior,
Savior, my life belongs to you.
Sing, Master,
Master, Redeemer,
my life belongs,
my life belongs to you.
Come on, lift it up and say, I'm yours.
I'm yours, I'm yours, I'm yours forever. I'm yours, I'm yours, I'm yours.
Sing, Lord, I'm yours.
Lord, I'm yours, I'm yours, I'm yours forever. I'm yours, I'm yours,
my
yours.
Sing, my heart is yours,
my heart is yours. It's yours forever. It's yours, it's yours, it's yours.
My life is yours,
my life is yours,
it's yours. Surrender, say, I surrender. Sing, Jesus, I surrender. One more time, sing, I surrender, I surrender. Your song this morning, say, whatever you ask, whatever you ask of me, I surrender. Oh, whatever you ask of me, whatever you ask of me, I surrender. Everything I have belongs to you, whatever you ask of me,
whatever you ask of me, I surrender.
Withholding nothing, Lord, whatever you ask of me,
whatever you ask of me, I surrender.
My dreams, my everything, Lord, whatever you ask of me,
whatever you ask of me, I surrender.
Come on, church, just take this moment to just surrender unto you.
Oh God, we surrender. Jesus, we surrender. Lord, I'm yours, I'm yours, I'm yours forever. I'm yours, I'm yours, I'm yours. Lord, I'm yours, I'm yours, I'm yours forever. I'm yours, I'm yours, I'm yours. Whatever you ask of me, I surrender. Whatever you ask of me, I surrender.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We praise you. We glorify you. Thank you. We can come to you with our all, with our everything, with our brokenness, oh God. Thank you for we are assured, we are accepted, and we have a seat on the table. We give you glory and we give you praise. Hallelujah. We praise you, Jesus. We honor you, Lord. Thank you, for we are yours. Thank you for whoever believes in you, they become a child of God. Thank you for you have called us yours, oh Jesus, Father. We are assured beyond anything and everything that we belong to the Most High God. Hallelujah.
I want to thank the Lord for you. Let's appreciate our worship team one more time. We celebrate them and we thank the Lord for them. These guys are dedicated. These guys are here every week to practice, to get their hearts right, so that they can be here to lead us in worship every Sunday. And so we do not take that for granted. We thank the Lord for them. Do we have any first-time visitors today? You're here for the very first time. You've never worshipped with us at Destiny. We want to recognize you and welcome you into the house of the Lord today. Any first-time visitors, if you're here, kindly lift up your hands. Any first-time visitors? Pandehi? Pandehi? There's one hiding somewhere here. Hallelujah. Where is that one? They have disappeared. Well, we thank the Lord. I want to encourage us to continue inviting people to come in and to celebrate the Lord with us every Sunday as we journey together and learn together, because the Lord is taking us somewhere. This Sunday morning, our bishop and Pastor Joe and Philip are not in church. They had an assignment, and Bishop and Pastor Joe have taken Philip on an assignment back home, but they are well. They've not gone to another church. You might be thinking, now Bishop Squeezy Atuli. We have been called to go into the world and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe everything the Lord has commanded us. I want to take us back to the book of 1 Kings chapter 17 from verse 7. For those of us who were here last Sunday, we took some time to share this, and I want to remind you of a couple of things we shared. It says, some time later, the brook dried up because there had been no rain in the land. Then the word of the Lord came to him, go at once to Zarephath in the region of Sidon and stay there. I have directed a widow there to supply you with food. So he went to Zarephath. When he came to the town gate, a widow was gathering sticks. He called to her and asked, would you bring me a little water in a jar so I may drink? As she was going to get it, he called, and bring me please a piece of bread. Verse 12, and surely as the Lord your God lives, she replied, I don't have any bread, only a handful of flour in a jar and a little olive oil in a jug. I'm gathering a few sticks to take home, make a meal for myself and for my son that we may eat it and die. Elijah said to her, don't be afraid, go home, do as you have said, but fast. Make a small loaf of bread for me from what you have and bring it to me, and then make something for yourself and for your son. For this is what the Lord God of Israel says, the jar of flour will not be used up and the jug of oil will not run dry until the day the Lord sends rain on the land. Last week, if you are here, I shared, and I want to remind us that the Lord has put it in our hearts to come together because there's a need in the house and we need to meet that need. Every Sunday we record our services and we put them online. We have a YouTube channel, we are on Facebook, we are on Twitter, we are on Instagram, we are also on TikTok. Bwana asifiwe. Even the gospel has to be TikToked. Bwana asifiwe. We are putting dance videos on TikTok, but dance videos with worship music and captions of the sermon. So if you're on TikTok, find Destiny Chapel and like it. You follow the way, the truth, and the life that we preach here at Destiny. If you're on Facebook and you haven't liked our page, I want to urge you, go and like our page. If you are on YouTube, subscribe to our channel. If you're on Instagram, go there and be part of what's happening. And also, when our media team posts out videos every week, sambaza, zisambaze, kila mahali, usisambaze za njugush peke yake, hata za Destiny pia unaeka kwa hiyo oda yako unasambaza everywhere. Because that word needs to go far and wide. And so, because of what we are doing, we need to equip our media team. The digital mixer we've been using belongs to Destiny Community Chapel. They've been so gracious to allow us to use it, and we've been using it for a long time. It's time to get ours. The lights we are using belong to CMM. And soon enough, CMM will be needing them. We need our own lights. The cameras we are using belong to Nick and CMM. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. So we need our own cameras. We need our own digital mixer. We need our own lights, because there's so much work that needs to be done. And the Lord has put it in our hearts to raise ₦1,000,000 to be able to get all those things done plus more. We need a new keyboard. This keyboard speaks in tongues. It can play notes that are not on the musical scale. Ask Donna. Pastor Donna can tell you. Sometimes he presses something and the sound that comes forth is a sound he's never had before. So we need a new keyboard. And so the Lord has put it in our hearts to raise ₦1,000,000. And this is how we are doing it. Just like the Lord spoke to the widow, the Lord needs to speak to you. Seek him and ask him how much he wants you to give. not based on your income or lack of an income. This lady had nothing, yet the Lord directed the man of God to a lady who only had food enough for one meal for her and her son, and then they die. So it's not based on your income. It's based on the word the Lord gives to you. For those of us who were here last Sunday, how many have already prayed and the Lord has given you a figure? Me, he has. Josephine and Mike, he has. Anybody else? Hallelujah. I can see Marion is lifting up her hand. For the rest of us, it means two things. Either you haven't prayed or you're praying and the Lord has not told you. If you haven't prayed, start praying. If you're praying and the Lord has not told you, keep praying. If the Lord tells you not to give, atutaki pesa yako. Let me say that again. If the Lord tells you not to give, we do not want your money. We only want what the Lord tells you to give. For those of us who are watching online, the same applies to you because you are reaping the benefits of what we are raising money for. Speak to the Lord. Ask him to tell you what figure to give towards what we are seeking to put together. Whatever he tells you to give, give. If he tells you not to give, don't give. Keep enjoying the services online. Keep rejoicing. There's therefore now condemnation. Why? Because we want to be obedient to the word of the Lord. So remember, 3rd of October is the day we will give. This is over and above what you give monthly, what you give weekly. So I would encourage you, seek the face of God and allow the Lord to show you what he wants you to give towards this. Remember, once again, our target is to raise $1 million to be able to equip our media team and our sound team so that we can keep moving forward in the direction that the Lord is taking us. Are you ready to give this morning? Hallelujah. If you need a giving envelope, our ushers will attend to you. Hallelujah. You can lift up your hands and they will hand you an envelope. And as we get prepared to give, a couple of announcements. Number one, for all our Fusion leaders, remember this Saturday, I believe it's the 18th, we are gathering together right here from 2 until 4:30 for a time of celebration and equipping. Iron sharpens iron. So if you are a Fusion leader, please avail yourself for 2.5 hours. Let's learn together. Let's grow together. Let's sharpen one another. And let's continue to go in the direction that God is leading us. And like I told the first service, when we say we are beginning at 2, it means we are beginning at? When we say we are beginning at 2, it means we are beginning at? It means you are here by 10 to 2 and we are beginning at 2. So that we can end on time. We begin on time and we end on time. And I told the first service something that I was taught many, many years ago. Before time is on time. Say that with me. On time is late. After time is unthinkable. Meaning if you're beginning at 2, be here at 2, 10 minutes to 2. Don't come at 2. If you're coming in at 2, you're late. If you're coming in at 10 minutes after 2, may the Lord help you. Hallelujah. Well, have you given? I want us to pray before we invite the speaker of the word today. Heavenly Father, here we are, your children, with your gifts, with our gifts. Through what you've given us, we bring back a portion to you to say thank you. Thank you that we can give, Lord. We don't take it for granted. Here we are today. We give not reluctantly or under compulsion, but because we are cheerful givers. And Lord, we know that you've gone before us, my Father, and you have given us everything we need, my Father, for this life. And so, Lord, we celebrate and we thank you. As we go out again this week, we ask that you would bless the work of our hands, because everything we do as unto the Lord. We thank you in Jesus' name. And everybody say the good loud amen. Hallelujah. Well, are you ready for the word? 5 people are ready for the word. It is okay. Those 5 people, we thank the Lord for you. Hallelujah. Are you ready for the word? Yeah. Hallelujah. Shiro is making signs and wonders for me, and I'm wondering what the signs and wonders are for, but I've remembered I want to release all our children to go for their service and all the preteens and teens. If you can make your way for your service, let's celebrate our children as they make their way for their service. Hallelujah. Asanteni sana. Mubarikiwe. Has the sermon series we have been doing over the last couple of weeks been a blessing to you? Ama mwezi multitask? Amwezi give mwangalie watu wao wakienda na mjibu swali? Bwana asifiwe. Let me give you some time to settle down. Hallelujah. Buona asifiwe. There are some seats in the front. You can move to the front. Kuna viti zingine hapa. Wale wako nyuma songeni songeni mbele. Hallelujah. This is one of the announcements in church that I find very interesting. That when you tell people to move to the front, they look at you and they think, I don't think you're talking to me. I think you're talking to other people. Buona asifiwe. But when it's something else, like kama ni line ya chakula. Buona asifiwe. Kama ni line ya chakula. Hey, no one tells you. Kwanza you fight to be at the front. Everybody wants to play. Sit at the front. It's always good to sit huku na mbele. Well, has this series been a blessing to you? How many people can say this series has impacted and changed their lives? Well, we thank the Lord for that. Well, we are continuing with where we left off last week. For the last 2 weeks, Pastor Daniel has been talking to us about the way, the truth, and today we are talking about the life. And having had the privilege of being here in the first service, I want to tell you, kama uko na kalamu na karatasi ziweke karibu. Kama kiti yako iko na seatbelt, tafadhali funga. Because today he is going to take you somewhere you've probably never been before, and it's going to be a blessing. So, ladies and gentlemen, Destinites, I want you to arise on your feet and help me welcome our senior associate pastor, Pastor Daniel Kamande. Hallelujah! Bwana asifiwe. Karibu sana kwa ndugu.
Awesome. Awesome. Can we pray? Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you. We love you. We honor you, Lord. Father, you're not surprised that we are here. Everyone who is gathered here is here by design and by your divine will. So I thank you and I bless you that you have given me the opportunity to bring your word to your people. I pray in the name of Jesus that whatever you had in mind to achieve through me in this service, in the lives of your people, may I be a vessel and a tool in your hands, in the name of Jesus. I bless your people with listening and hearing, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that no one and nothing can hinder your purpose in the lives of your people this afternoon, in the name of Jesus. That after this, Lord, everyone, especially you, you will look and say that we did what you wanted us to do. We thank you and we honor you for your word that is flowing through me. In Jesus' name, glory be to God. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Do you believe you're here by God's purpose? Awesome. So if you're here by God's purpose, please pay attention. Tell your neighbor, pay attention. The cheapest thing to buy is attention. Amen. Yes. Awesome. Awesome. Ah, kwani mshaka? Ai, aya simameni tusome neno. Awesome. Can we read? One, two, go. Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And we have looked at what? The way, the truth. Today we are looking at what? The life. Say the life. Now, I want you to notice something. When Jesus got to the life, he didn't add anything else. He stopped. When he said, I am the way, he thought, that's not enough. I am the truth, he thought, still not enough. Then he said, I am the life. And when he got there, he knew that he had described it completely. Because, let me tell you, brothers and sisters, when you understand that thing he's calling life, your life will never be the same again. Let me tell you, the reason why you see Christians that are inconsistent or a Christian that is living a life that is not a good testimony is because they have not understood that thing that he is calling the life. Say amen. Amen. So, of course, life is not breathing in and out. Because Jesus said, I am the life. And Jesus is not breathing in and out. So whatever we are looking at is actually a person. His name is who? Jesus. Is it true? All right. You can have your seat. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I believe and I pray that you have your notebook and a pen, or you have a phone that is nice. You have a smartphone. I believe you don't have a stupid phone. Is it true? Okay. Awesome. Look at this. Look at this. Look at it. Give me the first scripture. And kwani mmeongeza hii kitu volume? Toa, it's loud. Awesome. Now, Jesus said, I am the life. Now, when he said, I am the life, he used a Greek word, zoe. That is Z-O-E. Z-O-E. Kuna mafuta inaitwa zoe, sindio? Ya kujipaka, sindio? That's where they got the name. It's a Greek word for the life. Zoe. So when Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, and the zoe. Now, the reason why I'm saying that is because there are different kinds of life. For example, animals have their life. Do you understand? Plants have their life. Human beings have their life. God has his life. Did you hear me? Now, if you took Prophet Magak and gave him the life of a plant, he will start bearing fruits with this human body. This human body will start producing fruits. Why? Because the life in him is the life of what? A plant. Did you hear me? That means this human body manifests the life inside you. We can say it this way. When I say life, I mean nature. When you take the nature of a plant, if it was possible to take it and put it in Prophet Magak, he will start bearing maize. It's possible. If you took the life of an animal and put it in Prophet Magak will start behaving like an animal. If you take the life of God and put it inside Prophet Magak will behave like God. Did you hear me? Did you hear me? Someone is thinking, is that possible? Yes, it's possible. Look at it. It's there. Look, can we read 1, 2, go? They shall drive you now. Now, this is Nebuchadnezzar. And he's testifying what God did in his life when he exalted himself. You remember? Can we read 1, 2, go? They shall drive you from men. Your dwelling shall be with the beasts of the field. And they shall make you eat grass like oxen. They shall wet you with dew of heaven. And 7 times or 7 years shall pass over you till you know that the Most High rules in the kingdom of men and gives it to whomsoever he chooses. I wish politicians knew that verse. I wish they do it. Amen? Now look at this guy. God is saying, this guy will eat grass like an oxen. This guy will be wet with the dew of heaven like animals. Give me the next verse. Can we read 1, 2, go? That very hour, the word was fulfilled concerning Nebuchadnezzar. He was driven from men and ate grass like oxen. Look at his body. Look at his body. His body was wet with the dew of heaven till his hair had grown like eagle's feathers and his nails like bad crows. I told you, you can become an animal. You can. Umse alipata mabawa. Umse alipata mabawa, sini kweli? Na alipata crows. Why? Look at us. The next verse. How did God do it? Look at it. Look at it. One, two, go. Let his heart. Now that word heart means nature or life. Uh-huh. Let his heart be changed from that of a man. Let him be given the heart of a beast. And let 7 times or 7 years pass over him. This guy was an animal for 7 years. Anakula manyasi for 7 years. How was that possible? Because his nature was changed. Have you ever read the Bible says all things are possible with God? Yes. God can make you an animal. He can. All things are possible. Because remember, he created you. All right, give me the next verse. Look at this one. Now this one is soul. This one is soul. One, two, go. Then the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you, and you will prophesy with them and be turned into another man. Hey, look at me. Is it possible for you to be turned into another man? It's there. You can be turned into another man. It's possible. It's possible. How? Look at this verse. Look at it. Aha. Uh-huh. One, two, go. So it was when he had turned his back to go from Samuel that God gave him another heart or nature. And what happened? And all those signs came to pass that day. He was turned into another man. How? By God giving him another nature or life or heart. Is it true? All right. Now, the Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Is it true? That means he is another man. That means he is not the man that was born by his mother and father. He is another man. Is it true? That's why people like Pastor Timo, this one. Where? What when you are looking for service? This is Pastor Timo, I was telling you. This one. Simama nani. This is Pastor Timo. This is Pastor Timo. Pastor Timo was a hardcore criminal. This one. He was in prison. He got born again in prison. But today, Pastor Timo can't even hurt a fly. But he was a hardcore criminal. How did God do it? He changed his nature. Because if any man be in Christ Jesus, he is a new creation. He changed his heart and gave him a new nature. So he is the same. When you see him, you will call him Timo. But he inside, he is another man. The life inside is another one. Totally. The one that now does not take guns. He takes what? Bibles to massage. Oh, glory to God. Is it true? Look at this verse. Look at it. Uh-huh. That's how he does it. Look at it. He said what? I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. I will take the heart of stone out of your flesh and give you a heart of flesh. That's why you transform hard cores to softies. Only God can do it. Is it true? Then he says, I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes, and you will keep my judgments and do them. He's talking about the new man in Christ. Is it true? The born again man in Christ. So we are talking about what? Life means the life or the nature of God. Number one. Is it true? Zoe means life or nature of God. Now, look at this verse. We are reading together. Can we read? 1, 2, go. If we receive the witness of men. Now, in this scripture, you will find the word witness, record, testimony, or testify. All of those words mean the same thing. They mean testimony. Is it true? Actually, you can read, if we receive the testimony of men, the testimony of God is greater. You can change it and it's the same. So can we read 1, 2, go? If we receive the testimony of men, the testimony of God is greater. That tells me something. Men have a testimony, but the testimony of God is greater. And all of us who are seated here are living either by the testimony of men or the testimony of God. Mm-hmm. But he told you something. The testimony of God is greater. Mm-hmm. Glory to God. And he said, if we receive that of men, we should readily receive that which is of God. Yeah. Then look at it. Want to go? For this is the witness of God, which he has testified of his son. Verse 10. Look at it. He who believes in the Son of God has the witness in himself. He who does not believe God has made God or him a liar, because he has not believed the testimony that God has given of his Son. Verse 11. Look at it. This is important. This is important. And this is the testimony that God has given us Zoe. God has given us what? Zoe. That means God has given us the life and the nature of God. God has given us Zoe. And this Zoe is in his Son. That means this one you cannot find it in the shops. No matter how rich you are, this one is only found in the Son. That means there is one thing that God has given that cannot be found anywhere in this world. This one, God tells you what it is, and he tells you where it is found. He says he has given us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. Look at verse 12. Glory to God. Look at it. He who has the Son has Zoe. Glory to God. Now, how many of us are seated here and you know you're born again? You know. Born again. Those people who are lifting their hands, this is true about you. If you're born again and you know you're born again, he says, he who has the Son has life. Has the nature of God. So, just like Nebuchadnezzar started manifesting the nature of an animal, you should manifest the nature of God. Yes. 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 It's there. He who has this, that's the qualification. That's the qualification. It's not many things. Just have the Son. If you have the Son, you have it. That means in prayer, I can confess and say, I have the life of God in me. I can say it. And I will not be lying. I'll be agreeing with God. I have the life of God in me. And because I have it, I manifest it. I manifest his glory of God. Is it true? Yes. Look at the next statement. Go back. We have not finished that one. Look at the next statement. He who does not have the Son of God does not have life. Oh, oh man. You know, I told them in the first service, look, my brother, can I use you? I told them, look, if you are told, he who comes to the chapel has an iPhone 12 Pro. I saw it. It is 220,000 Kenya shillings. How? It beats my mind. How can I give 220 Kamulu Joska Muzim? Maguta. Is that possible? Okay. So he who comes to destiny has iPhone 12 Pro. He who does not come to Destiny Chapel has no iPhone 12 Pro. My brother, what does that tell you? It tells you that coming to Destiny Chapel has an advantage. It adds something into your life. Is it true? Is it true? That means he that has the Son has life. He that does not have the Son has no life. Between these two guys, who is better off? The one who has something. Is it true? Why are you envying sinners? Because they have Mercedes Benzes. Why are you envying sinners? Because they have big businesses. No, no matter what they have, you have something they will never have. Did you hear me? Did you hear me? So, guess what? Square your shoulders. Do you understand? Lift your head. Put your chin up. Walk with boldness. You know why? Because you have something they don't have. And that thing God has called it what? Life. Zoe. The nature of God. It is much better to drive a Range Rover with the life of God. Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. It is nice to live in a 7-bedroom house with the nature of God. Yes. You know why? Because you see, with that nature, you know, that nature is more important than the house. So out to test our Instagram. You don't need to. You don't need to. You know why? Because there is something more valuable than, you see, that means kututesa Instagram is just an empty life. It's true. Sini kweli? Yeah. That's where you're getting your value. No, for us, we know who we are. And guess what? We know what we have. We have something they are craving for. We have life. We do. We have Zoe. And guess what? He that does not have the Son of God does not have it. Guess what? No matter how high they are in society. No. No. It's not about your social status. It's about, do you have the Son or not? If you are high and you don't have the Son, you are just a tool in the hand of God. After he's through using you, you know what he will do? He will put the wheat in the store and the chaff he will burn. Yeah. You know, most influential people will be shocked that with all their influence, God will burn them in hell. He will. They will be shocked. What am I doing here? A whole me. There is no nice place. You just remember Lazarus and the rich man. Yes, remember. Yeah. Glory to God. Amen. Give me the next one. Look at verse 13. Look at verse 13. One, two, go. These things have I written unto you who believe in the name of the Son of God. Look at it. For a purpose. For a purpose. That means he wrote them for a purpose. He wrote them that we may do what? That you may know that you have eternal life. That means God wants us to know that we have Zoe. He wants us to know. The will of God is that everyone seated here knows that we have Zoe. Why? Because if you don't know, you will suffer. Is it true? You will suffer. You will suffer. And in life, it's all about what you know. You know that? Yesterday night, we were coming from somewhere. You know, this weekend has been my anniversary weekend. Fifth anniversary. Mm-hmm. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. So we were coming from somewhere. So when we are coming, I remembered, haya, shower head yet will Jamaica. Haya, na jumaji ilikuwa imepotea, so hatukuwa tunai need. Lakini kwa group nimeona caretaker amesema maji imerudi. Sasa tutaanza kuchemsha maji. You see, because I do not know how to fix a shower head. I will suffer for not knowing. It's true. I will suffer for not knowing it. So you know what I did? It was, I think, 10. Time ya curfew. I had to call an electrician and tell him how much is fixing shower head. Akaniambia. Akaniambia nitakuongelezea 100 ya kukuja usiku. So he came and fixed it. Guess what? He did not spend up there 10 minutes. 5 minutes he was done. And he had made money. Plus 100. You see, what you don't know in life will cost you. Will cost you. That's why he wants us to know that we have eternal life. Because if we don't know, itakukost. Itakukost. It will cost you. It will cost you. And God will be in heaven wondering, Aya, why are you suffering like this? Because God said, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. So it's nice. God wants us to know that we have. Did you notice what he wants us to know? He does not want us to know there is eternal life. He wants us to know that we have eternal life. Angalia. Mami, habari ya leo? Unanikalia mgeni lakini sawa tu. Wacha nikuulize mami. Mami, nikuulize swali. Nikisema I have money. I have 10,000 in my pocket. What does that mean to you? I have niko na 10,000 kwa mfuko. Na ni yangu. Niko na 10,000 na ni yangu. What does that mean to you, mami? It means you can use it because you have it. You can enjoy it. Unaweza toka hapa hivi ubuke SGR uende Mombasa, si ndio? Ukaji bambe. You can enjoy it because you have it. You can't enjoy what you don't have. Is it true? Neither can you use what you don't have. That's why he wants us to know that we have it. So that we do what? We use it and enjoy it. Why? Because it is the life of God. Now, if God was married, how would his marriage look like? If God was married, how would his marriage look like? Because he has given us his life to enjoy, but we have context in which we enjoy that life. One of it is marriage. If God was in business, how do you think he would run his business? If God was a parent, and yes, he is, how do you think he would parent his children? Do you think his nature would manifest in his parenting? It would. But now, we have that nature. And the will of God is we manifest it in everything in life. If God was employed, what kind of an employee do you think God would be? Do you think God will behave like that? Is that the nature of God? Hey, can you have coffee? Please stay at home. Please don't come. All right. Look at this one. Look at the next one. Look at the next one. Uh-huh. 1, 2, go. Uh-huh. No. It's okay. Uh-huh. It's okay. Give me the next one. 1 Timothy. 1 Timothy 4:8. Uh-huh. 1, 2, go. Can we read 1, 2, go? For bodily exercise profits a little. Watu wa gym meona. Na watu wa workout. Hey, watu wa gym naona. Bodily exercise. This is my friend Elijah. Napenda gym. Look at it. I didn't say it. Scripture said it. For bodily exercise profits a little. Unajua watu wa nini? Watu wa diet. Watu wa exercise. There is a way they behave as though life depends on it. No, it does not depend on it. It just profits a little. You know, if you don't eat, you know the way they, if you don't eat cabbages in 3 days a week, you know, it's like you will die. No, we will not die because it profits a little. But look at it. Look at the next one. But godliness is profitable for all things, including physically. That means if you are to ask God, God would rather have you live a godly life than go to the gym. Because it will profit you more to live a godly life. Because no one is godly that eats a lot. Yes. No one that is godly that will inject things in their bodies that are harmful to their bodies. Yeah. Godly people go to sleep when they are tired. They don't push their bodies to prove something to someone. When you're tired, sleep. Yeah, sleep. Even Jesus slept. Yeah, he slept. So godliness is profitable for all things. Look at what he says. Having promise of the life that now is and of that which is to come. That means as you exercise yourself in godliness, you will enjoy Zoe now. You cannot enjoy Zoe in ungodliness. As you exercise godliness in your life, you will enjoy what? Zoe. It's true. It's true. Yeah, it's true. Amen. Number two. Life is a revelation of the Father and of His Son. Number two. Life is a revelation. Number one. Life is the nature of God. Uh-huh. Life is the revelation of the Father and the Son. Look at this scripture. Look at it. 1, 2, go. Can we read 1, 2, go? Jesus spoke these words, lifted up his eyes to heaven, and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son also may glorify you. Look at verse 2. As you have given him authority over all flesh, that he should give Zoe to as many as you have given him. Number three. And this is Zoe, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. That means Zoe is knowing the only true God and his son, Jesus Christ. You know why? Because you cannot know God and remain the same. It's not possible. Look at these evidences. Look at it. One, two, go. Look at this. Those who do wickedly against the covenant, he shall corrupt with flattery. But the people who know their God shall be strong and carry out great exploits. You cannot know God and be weak. The knowledge of God is the cure of weakness. Did you hear me? The people who know their God. Did you notice he talked about flattery? Not the people who flatter their God. Not the people who know their God. They shall be strong. And guess what? And carry out great exploits. Say amen.
Amen.
If I was you and I was looking for great exploits in life, I would go for the knowledge of God. I would seek to know God more. Because the more you know him, the stronger you become. And the more empowered you are to carry out great exploits. Glory to God. Look at this other evidence that the knowledge of God affects you. Look at it. One, two, go. Simon Peter, a bond servant and an apostle of Jesus Christ, to those who have obtained like precious faith with us by the righteousness of our God and Savior Jesus Christ. Look at it. It's here. It's here. Look at verse 2. Verse 2. Look. Grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ. Actually, this is New King James. King James says, through the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ. That means you can have grace and peace multiplied to you through the knowledge of God. That means the more you know God, the more grace and peace will be multiplied, not added, multiplied. That means you can have an abundance of grace and an abundance of peace. He calls that peace what? Peace that surpasses understanding. You know why? They cannot understand why you are going all through all this and you're peaceful. How can someone be going through all this and still remain calm? It's called the peace of God. The peace of God. Is it true? Yeah. The peace of God. It can be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ. Look at this other one. Look at it. One, two, go. As his divine power has given to us all things that pertains to Zoe and godliness through the knowledge of him who called us by glory and virtue. All things that pertains to Zoe and godliness have been given to us. But now they manifest in your life through the knowledge of God. I told you, if I was you, I would go for knowledge, the knowledge of God. I would seek to know God more. And you cannot discover God scientifically. God can only be revealed. Is it true? That means you can only find out, you can only know God in prayer through his word. Hallelujah. Is it true? Yes. Kama wewe na maombi muko hivi. Wewe unapita huko maombi inapita hapa. Haya. Mdomo yako itajaa BBI. It's true. Ukifungua mdomo tu ni siasa. It's true. Amen. Ah, look at the other one. The other one is what? Life, number three. Life is a realm. Life is a realm. Number three. Can we read? Let us read this one. One, two, go. Most assuredly, I say to you, he who hears my word and believes in him who has sent me has Zoe, everlasting life, Zoe. Then he says, and shall not come into judgment, but has passed from death into life. Listen. Look. Hey, how are you? Stand. Together with my mom. Let me use my mother. I trust her. She will not think I am mad. Look. Let's assume these are sisters, born of the same mother, living in the same house. Sinigweli. Then one day, one of the sisters, this one, goes out and meets these preachers that preach in the matatu. And she listens and thinks, "Haya, by the way, is that true?" Then she approaches the preacher in the matatu and says, "By the way, minataka kuokoka." And she's born again. Her sister does not know what has happened. Is it true? He says, "He who hears my words and believes has Zoe and will not come to judgment because he has passed from death to life." Now, she goes back home in the same house, under the same roof. But now she believes in Jesus Christ. The sister does not. Now, this one that believes has Zoe. And the Bible says, will not come to judgment. Why? Because she has passed from death into life. That means they are under the same roof, but one is in the realm of death. The other one is in the realm of life. Did you hear me?
Yes.
That means seated here in this church, there are two categories of people. Someone is seated here. We are in the same physical building, but spiritually, you are in death and your neighbor is in life. And what proves that? If both of you were to drop dead, you will know you are in death and your neighbor was in life. Why? Because of where you will go. You will go to what? Judgment. Is it true?
Yeah.
If you're here and you're not born again, if I was you, I would stand up and get born again. I'm, even now, I'm telling you, it's true. It's true. Did you hear me? Look at it. Thank you. Thank you, my mom. Thank you. Thank you so much. Look at it. Let us read. One, two, go. Not this one. The other one. The next one. Aha. Can we read? One, two, go. If your hand or foot causes you to sin, cut it off and cast it from you. It is better for you to enter into life lame and maimed rather than have two hands and two feet and be cast into an everlasting fire. So life is a realm. Is it true? Yes. It's a realm that we are in, and when we die or Jesus Christ come back, it's not that we will go to. We will continue in. Did you hear me? If you don't have life in you right now, when Jesus comes back, you are done. Say amen. Look at this one. The other one. Give me the next one. The next scripture. This bite. Thank you. Look at this. Can we read? One, two, go. At that time, Michael shall stand up, the great prince who stands watch over the sons of your people. Man, one day we will talk about that. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was since there was a nation. Even to that time, and at that time, your people shall be delivered. Everyone who is found written in the book. Look at verse 2. Verse 2. Give me verse 2 of the same. Uh-huh. Want to go? And many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth, that means the graves, shall awake, look at it, some to everlasting life, some to shame and everlasting contempt. Amen. Then give me the other one. Want to go? Then he will answer them, saying, assuredly, I say to you, inasmuch as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. Then he says what? And these will go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into eternal life. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So it's a realm. Amen. It's a realm. Number four. When he said the life, it's the blessing. It's the blessing. It's the blessing. Look at it. Look at this one. Can we read one to go? Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious oil upon the head, running down on the beard of Aaron, running down on the edges of his garment. Look at verse 3. It is like the dew of Hermon, descending upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commanded the blessing, life forevermore. That means life forevermore, or Zoe, is the blessing. That means if you have Zoe in you, you have the blessing in you. If you have the blessing in you, it means you are blessed. No one who has the life of God in them is cursed. Because the life of God in them is the blessing. Amen. So what do? You start saying, the blessing is in me. I am a blessed man. I am a blessed woman. Everything about me is blessed. You start saying it because you believe God. My children are blessed. My finances are blessed. Because the life of God is in me. It's working in me and it's working with me. That means the blessing is working with you. You start saying it. Everything I put my hands on is blessed. In the name of Jesus. Is it true? Listen. Listen. There is no curse that is strong enough than this life. Let me tell you. There is no curse that is strong enough than this life. This life is stronger. That means when you believe it and start saying it, it doesn't matter how many curses have followed you up until now. You see, you know, I like teaching God's people. You know why? You na futa ma pastor wengi wa madhabahu wa kuvunja madhabahu na kufuvunja laana za kizazi na wafuta kazi. Because when you know you have the life of God in you, sini kweli? When you know you have the life of God in you, do you need me to come and vunja madhabahu kwenyu? We enda uvunje bana. Ai, we tuachishe. Si ni ukweli? Kama kuna madhabahu, we enda. Si Mungu amekuambia uko na uhai yake, epeleka hiyo uhai kwenyu. Na waambie, by then unasikianga huku kuna wachai wanazumbua watu. Na nimekuja, and I have the life of God in me. Yeah. You see, you have to be bold like Jesus. Is it true? Yeah. And when you zimame, useme, nasikia kuku kuna wachai, nimekuja, na useme na nguvu. Usiseme nini, usiseme kwa bedroom. Nasikia kuku kuna wachawi. That is not like God. You have the nature of God. The Bible says the righteous shall be as bold as a lion. That means be bold. When you're making those faith proclamations, make them boldly. You say,
At 40, you have killed everybody in my family. I am not dying at 40. Yes, you say it. You see, when you say it, you have announced war. It's nice. It's nice. Whoever responds, respond to them. It's true. Tell them I have the life of God in me. And in the name of Jesus, I am living my life full. No one is cutting it short in Jesus' name. No one. No one. Is it true? Yeah, because these things God tells us for a reason. To use them. Say amen. Amen. Say I am a blessed man. Say I am a blessed man. Say I am a blessed woman. In the name of Jesus. Say the blessing of God is in me. Yeah. So when you think what blessings. When you talk what blessings. Yeah. Amen. Aha. Give me the next verse. Look at this one. Aha. Give me the next verse after this. Give me the next verse. Aha. Can we read 1, 2, go? I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. That means he calls the life what? Blessing. He calls death what? Cursing. Is it true? Then look at what he says. Therefore, choose life that both you and your descendant may live. Say amen. Choose what? Life. That means choose the blessing. God told you to do what? To choose. So the choice is yours. Sinukweli. Then, how can you choose life? Then, ati kuna mtu amekaa mahali, anachinja kuku, anataka kukuchagulia laana. Na wewe ulishachagua life. Who will God honor? Because God told us in the scriptures, choose life. So if I come and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I choose life. You want to tell me someone can break that one? Bible, Jesus actually said, the scriptures cannot be broken. You see, brothers and sisters, we have to put our confidence in God's word. Do you understand? Our boldness has to be in God's word. And guess what? Guess what he says? Guess what he says? That both you and your descendant may live. Let me end here. Let me end here. Glory to God. Give me 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians 7. Verse number 14. 1 Corinthians 7. Aha. Go back to 12. So that we understand. He said, choose life that both you and your descendant may live. Sinukweli. Pastor Jemo, you know, I've always asked myself, if it is true, me and you, we have eternal life, how comes when we give birth to children, they don't come with that nature of God, yet we have it? You know me, I ask God questions. Yeah. So I asked God, if it is true, I have your life and your nature in me, how comes my children were not born with that nature? God is gracious, man. He answered me. You know what he told me? He told me, because eternal life can only be gotten or received through believing. So someone has to believe. It's not gotten through birth. But it has an impact on your children. And then he gave me this scripture. Look at it. So it's true, because eternal life, you have to get it through believing. But eternal life has an impact on your children. Look at it. We are reading, all of us. We are reading. Read. 1, 2, go. But the rest, I, not the Lord, say, if any brother has a wife who does not believe and she is willing to live with him, let him not divorce her. Sinigweli. So kama mnyinyi wawili mmeokoka, na if a brother has a wife who does not believe, so you, my brother, has a wife who does not believe. The Bible says, if your wife is willing to live with you, you don't go. You don't divorce her. Because now you have believed in Christ. That's what he's saying. So if this one is the one who is free to choose whether to stay or to go, you are not free to choose anything. If she says, mina kana wewe, unakwama na yeye. Sinikweli? That's what the Bible is saying. Verse 13, look at it. Verse 13. Mm-hmm. Aha. And a woman who has a husband who does not believe, guess what? When you believe, what do you get? Zoe. Eternal life, sinikweli. That means, and a woman who has a husband who does not have Zoe, if he is willing to live with her, let her not divorce. Look at verse 14. Look at verse 14. One, two, go. For the unbelieving husband is sanctified by the wife. That means this husband that is not, does not have Zoe because he does not believe, is sanctified. Oh, makatabaya kalabaya. Oh, glory to God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Look, look. It's not the husband affecting the wife. It is the wife affecting the husband. That means the unsanctified husband is sanctified by the believing wife. Sinikweli. Aya, look, look at it. Then he says what? And the unbelieving wife is sanctified by the husband. Then look at the next statement. Otherwise, in other words, if it was not true what I have said, if what I have just said, that the husband sanctifies the unbelieving wife and the believing wife sanctifies the unbelieving husband, if it was otherwise, if it was not true, look at it. Your children would be unclean, but now they are holy. Pake talaki paya. Glory to God. That means our children, we don't need to be born again, both of us. If one of us is born again, the children are holy. That means Satan has no claims over them. Because holy means set apart for God. So it is true, they don't come with the nature, but they are set apart for God. That means God has taken responsibility over those children. They are holy. That means God is saying they are mine. Because they are born by who? One believing couple. One spouse is believing. Now think. Both of you are born again. Do you understand the power of those children? Those are not ordinary children. I'm telling you. Those are not ordinary children. Those are holy, holy children. Yeah. That means if you know this, none of your children will go to hell. None. Why? Because God has assumed responsibility over your children. He has said they are holy. And look, look, look. If it was otherwise, the children would be unclean. That means non-believers that give birth to children, they give birth to what? Unclean children. That's the scriptures. But a couple that has only one spouse born again, the impact of eternal life, the impact of eternal life sanctifies the children. The impact. Oh, if I was young and I had not given birth and I'm not born again, I would give birth, I would be born again today. You know why? So that I get a born again woman. So that I give birth to holy children. Glory to God. So some of us Some of us, listen, some of us, you know, my father is not born again, even until today. He's not born again, but my mom is here. Yeah. Guess what? And I'm holy and clean. Listen, the things I have done, ask her. But every time I went this way, something, there was something in my life. Listen, let me give you a testimony. One time, I was in class 8, and we had finished KCB. That day, I was to be taken to be initiated into Mungeke. Actually, we had arranged everything. Everything we had arranged. Everything. I was to go to Kiandutu. You know Kiandutu? Yes. Kiandutu in Thika. That's where they used to initiate people. Yes. So I was to be initiated into Mungeke. So that day, guess what happened? I overslept. They left me. 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 And when they came back, they said they will never take me there. And we broke friendship. Because I didn't show up. Why? I overslept. This one. And guess what? I don't think she knew that. I don't think she knew this scripture. She just knew watoto wangu hawezi potea. Guess, think about you operating with this knowledge. When you look at your children, no matter what they do, listen, you do whatever you are doing, you are holy. You are holy. You know what that means? After you have done everything you are doing, you will still come back to God. So you don't curse your children. No matter what they do, no matter how they misbehave, laugh. When they come home, cook for them. Yeah. And tell them, how are you, holy son? Even if they are drunk. Yeah. It's true, because the scriptures cannot be broken. So just because they have misstepped does not break the scriptures. The scriptures remain true forever. Glory to God. Tunaweza malizia hapo. Thank you. God bless you. Is anyone here who wants to be born again? Even now. You want to be born again now. Glory. You want to move from death to life. You're welcome. So if there is anyone who wants to be born again, glory to God. Listen. We live by God's word. Is it true? Yes. So I've shown you something. The impact of eternal life on children. I've shown you something. It's true. They have to believe for themselves. But guess what? They have an easy time believing. You know why? They are holy. That means, look, they are inclined. Of course, angalia. Our wengine ni unclean. Our wako ni holy. Of course, their inclination will be different. So they have an inclination towards God. So you know what your job as a parent is, to incline them, help them go the right direction. Is it true? So, badaya kushinda ukiwaekea, baby shark. Hey, mommy shark, tuturu, tuturu, tuturu. Mommy shark, tuturu, tuturu, mommy shark. No, no, you are taking them in the wrong direction. Waeke, Papa Abraham had many sons. Those are the cartoons in the phone. Hallelujah. Those are the cartoons you download. Yes. Because you are helping them do what? Go the right direction. You are stirring up the holiness. Don't kill it with funny cartoons. Are mami beniten, beniten, beniten. Watafutie super book. Waeke super book. Wanaskiza Bible hawaelewi ni nini, lakini waskize. Yeah, faith comes by hearing. It's true. It's true. By the time you are releasing a phone to them, you are sure you have grounded them. It's, don't seek to be fashionable. We are not called to be fashionable. Did you hear me? Don't seek to be fashionable at India in a trend. We don't go with what is trending. No, we go with what is true. What is true and what is right. That's what we go with. So say me, ayi watoto wangu wanaachwa nyuma. Hawasikizangi. Wacha waachwe nyuma. Wacha waachwe. Kama ni Bible unawaekea, wacha waachwe. The day they show up in school, their mental aptitude, their need of understanding and grasping things will be on another level. I'm telling you the truth before God. I'm telling you the honest truth. It's true. Because you can't have the life of God and be the tail. No, you are the head, not the tail. So your children can't be holy and be getting funny things. No, you say you are holy. Your mind is holy. It has to understand. Yeah. And in the meanwhile, you are looking for what they may, maybe their thing is not school. So you are looking for it. What is it? Maybe their thing is something else. Yeah. So now peleka shule kujua kuhesabu pesa. Na kujua kuongea kizungu. Okay, thank you. Stand up. Glory to God. Thank you. Say, I have the life of God in the name of Jesus. And because I have it, I will use it and I will enjoy it in the name of Jesus. Say, I am different from non-believers. I have something that they don't have. And therefore, my life is different in Jesus' name. Amen. Awesome. Amen. Awesome. Awesome. All right. Help me appreciate it. Now, you know, Pastor Jemo has given me this pulpit for 3 weeks. Is it true? If you are aware, Pastor Jemo was ordained 1 month or 2 months ago. Is it true? As our senior pastor. Yet he has given me the pulpit for 3 weeks. He has not preached 1 year. No. He has not even preached 2 months, I think. Just weeks. Three. Sasa, that may not make sense to you because you're in destiny. Somewhere else, kuna senior associate, they are warming the bench. Do you understand? Yes. But I've ministered to you guys 3 weeks. Think about it. So I want us to honor our senior pastor in Jesus' name. Yes. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You know, it's so nice to serve under secure men of God. They don't have anything to prove. You know, listen, no matter how rich Jesse gets, you're still his father. His riches will not make him your father.
No.
It's true. So no matter how anointed we are or blessed we are, we will never be the grace over the house. We are the sons and we know. Is it true? Yeah. And I know your desire is for Jesse to do well.
Yes.
Actually to bypass you by far. Thank you. That's the blessing of serving under secure grace. Amen. You don't try to kill the gift and the anointings of God.
Yes.
You raise them.
Yes.
Because you are a secure grace.
Yes.
No one can be Pastor Jemu. Can you be Pastor Jemu?
No.
Are you the senior pastor? You're not. You're not. So, we live in harmony. Is it true?
Yes.
And that's Destiny Chapel for us. Glory to God. Thank you. Thank you.
Bwana asifiwe. Do you have life? There's a song we used to sing back in the day. It says, I've got the life of God in me. You know that song? I've got his love, his nature, and his ability. I've got the life of God in me. You know, we say Destiny Chapel will be known for several things. One of them is that we will be students of the word. We will love the word. We will love prayer. And we will love one another. So if you're part of this church, my friend, let me tell you, being the senior pastor is hard work, but if you have wisdom and God has given you 5 pastors, why should you toil and struggle? One has the grace to teach. Another has the grace to lead worship. Another one has the grace for soul winning. And another one is a teacher in the making. Hey, you don't know what's in store for you. Help me introduce. Because God has given us men and women. Let me tell you something. Where is Betty? Is Betty here? She's upstairs. We're doing a class. And in this class, one of the things we are learning is how to teach. Here? See, there are people in this church who can teach. The Betty you see walking around, the Kate you see here leading worship, these guys are teachers. Even Dan on sound up there is a teacher. If you give him the mic, hata sita sita, na wala hata saba saba, he will have something to say. Nick here on camera, msifikiri haju kuongea. And then there's Pastor Joe's wife, Rachel. What? Hey. My friend, you are in the right church. If you leave this church without knowing the word, shida siyo ikanisa, shida siyo achungaji, shida niwe, niwewe. So let's be students of this word. Go out this week knowing that you are blessed. Because Pastor Dan has told us the blessing is what? It's not what's in the bank account. If you don't have life, what's in the bank account doesn't make sense. Because you won't get to enjoy it. What you have on the inside of you is the life of God. That's the blessing. Go out this week, enjoy it, and share it with others. God bless you. Hallelujah. We are dismissed for today. We'll connect again next week.